We're going to calculate the concentration of an ethylene glycol solution, and we're going to calculate that in molarity. First thing, you should write down the definition of molarity. It'll help you focus and see which pieces you need. And the definition is moles of solute per liter of solution. And you should write it that way. Don't just write moles over liters. Put in the solute and the solution in the definition. It'll help you pull out the pieces more easily. Now, liters of solution, not solvent. So we better make sure that we've got some way to get the volume of solution. Well, we've got that. We're told how much solution we want. And in the definition of molarity, we've got moles. But the problem gives us the solute in mass. So how do you convert between mass and moles? You need the molar mass of ethylene glycol. And something else you may have noticed, you're told the temperature. And the temperature is not needed in this problem. So in this case, it's a distractor. You do have to watch more complicated problems that use molarity, however, because volume for aqueous and liquids and things like that can be dependent upon temperature. So your expectation is if the temperature changes, then the volume of aqueous solutions will change. But in this case, it's just for color commentary. So let's start with the moles of solute. Now, I'm not going to break this up into pieces. I'm not going to calculate the moles of solute first, and then the liters of solution second, and then divide it third. I'm going to do this in a chain calculation. So we'll start with the given mass of solute. And then we need to use the molar mass to convert. Are you going to multiply by the molar mass? Or are you going to divide by the molar mass? You divide by the molar mass. To check, look, our grams cancels. That's good. And we have moles remaining. And the mole unit is in the numerator. That's good, because we don't want 1 over moles. We want moles. Now we need to divide by the volume of solution. And so we divide by the 500.0 milliliters. And what do we have to do with that? Yeah, we have to convert that to liters. So the relationship is 1,000 milliliters per liter, or 1 milliliter is 0.001 liters. Either one is fine. You're going to have to use the milliliter to liter conversion quite often in the lab, because of the solution unit molarity, which has liters of solution in it. Milliliters cancels. What are we doing on units? We have moles over liters. That's good. That's what we want. Now we do our multiplication and division. You get 8.93 moles per liter. So unit-wise, you can write the units as moles per liter, or you can use capital M. The recommendation is to not use capital M and not refer to this as an 8.93 molar solution. That's still commonly done. The reason why it's recommended not to do that is when people say molar, it sounds like it's per mole, when molarity is per liter. So the recommended one is really the top one, moles per liter. But you have to get used to seeing capital M. Not lowercase m, has to be capital M. Your quick numerical check. The concentration of pure water is approximately 55 moles per liter. So if you're calculating an aqueous solution, then the numerical value better be less than 55 moles per liter.